Welcome to our training on how to build chatbot, a self-learning approach. In this session, we are going to create our first chatbot using Microsoft Bot Framework. Let's get started. There are a lot of chat frameworks available. Big companies and startups interested in chatbots are making it easier for users, different disciplines to build their own bots, whether they are familiar with developing aspects or not. The superpowers of the internet, like Microsoft and Facebook, release complete frameworks for building massive bots, and many startups joined the race with assistance. This section examines some of these frameworks and their offerings. Microsoft Botnet Framework. Earlier in 2016, Microsoft launched Microsoft Botnet Framework and its initial iteration of the Bot Connector API with Bot Builder and Bot Connector SDK. So now you are already clear, since 2016 we have the Microsoft Botnet Framework available, which has a Botnet Connector API, a Bot Builder and a Bot Connector SDK. Since construction, Microsoft has actively worked in improving the REST and SDK API to be ready for the future, including better support for attachments as well as improved performance. It is a complete offer to create and deploy high quality bots. Bots developers all face the same problem. Bots require basic input-output. They must have linguistic and dialogue skills. They must be performing, reactive and evolving, and they must connect to users. The Microsoft Botnet Framework offers many capabilities. The Bot Framework provides everything needed to build, connect, manage, and publish smart bots that naturally interact whenever the user speaks. From text SMS to Skype, Slack, Facebook Messenger, Kick, Office 365 Mail, and the other popular services. There is even a platform as a service option on Azure available, which is an intelligent serverless bot service that scales on demand. In short, chatbots can offer a user experience much more fluid and satisfying than applications, transforming the messaging into multi-service platforms. And do chatbots really jeopardize mobile applications? Time will tell. Will they jeopardize or not? The Microsoft Bot Framework provides a .NET SDK and a Node.js SDK. They make building bots easier because of the features they afford, such as built-in prompt and dialogues. We will be using built-in prompts and dialogues today. The REST API is implemented for those using other programming languages. The Bot Builder SDK is an open source project available on GitHub with the name Bot Builder. You can quickly fork it and you can associate with the project. Adding intelligence to a bot on Microsoft is included via Language Understanding Intelligent Service, and we call it as LUIS. This is important for you because in questions or in exams, it could have been asked that what an LUIS service is. So you have to tell them Language Understanding Intelligent Service is a Microsoft product for natural language processing. Cortana it has for voice understanding, and the Bing API is for search. After building a bot, it has to be registered, connected to channels and published. The framework provides a registration which produces the bot's app ID and password used for authentication. At this particular demonstration and within this particular demo video session, we will not be specifying any specific Microsoft ID. We'll be doing it in later sessions as soon as we progress further and once we will be deploying our bots on internet. Some channels are pre-configured on the framework, such as Skype and WeChat. As soon as the channel is configured, the bot can be shared with users. After publishing the bot, users can select it in the directory and add it to one or more of the configured channels they use. So today, we'll get started with an example. And the example which we'll follow is based on Bot Builder for Node.js, which is a powerful framework for constructing bots. It uses both guided interactions and more free-form ones where the possibilities are explicitly shown to the users. It models frameworks like Express and Restify will be able to help us in development of a good quality bot. Moreover, in order to get started with basics of Node.js, you can quickly go to Google and you can search for the Node.js part. Let's just see from where you can quickly get the basics of Node.js. You can proceed to google.com and you have to type in the information somewhat like this. Go to google.com, go to your search, type in Node.js Hackveda. You can quickly go to the search, and as soon as you search, you will get the information, and the very first link will take you to the training section wherein you can quickly register for the Node.js specific information. Here you have Node.js tutorial available. You can quickly click here on Node.js. We'll guide you with starting from the installations to step-by-step approach how you can quickly register with Node programming. Now let's get back to the discussion. So here, once you are done with the program, now let's get started with the example to build a bot builder. So in my case, I already have Node.js installed in my machine. So we'll get started with a command prompt. I'll use cmd.exe. I'm going to run this command prompt as an administrator. Let's run it as an administrator. Once the bot has been ready, so we would like to create one for this particular workshop. So let's call it as chatbot workshop. We'll move into this workshop, and here I'm going to create a directory for my first bot. So let's create mkdir first bot. This will be our first bot which we will be preparing. So we'll move into this first bot, and we are going to initialize this particular directory with the Node package manager. To do this, we can use npm, which stands for Node package manager, and we can init. Once we initialize, it will ask us some information about the project. As soon as we are done with specification of the information, our first initialization and a package.json file will be ready. So here you can see that this utility will walk you through creating a package.json file. It only covers the most common items and tries to guess sensible defaults. So you can quickly take help on JSON using npm help JSON. You can install packages. We will be using this command using save. These will be afterwards to install a package and save it as a dependency in the package.json file. So we'll be doing this as well. So let's get started. So my first project will be my first bot. Version will be 1.0.0. Description will be my first chat bot. We'll go to the entry point and we'll get started with index.js page. This will be loaded automatically. There will be no test command, no Git repository at the moment. Let's call this first bot by Hackveda. The author is, my name is Devanshu Shukla. The license will be licensed from Hackveda. Let's say it could be a standard license, or let's just use the ISC as a standard license. So here is your JSON created, and all this content will be stored into your package.json file. So your name is first bot, version is this, description my first chatbot, and all the information has been created. So would you like to save it? Yes, we like to save it. So now once we are done with saving, and if you quickly execute dir command here, you can see that package.json has been created here. Now once we are done with package.json, now we are going to install information for the packages which we need. So as I discussed earlier, for this example we are using Node.js, and I will be using Restify and a bot builder framework for Node.js, which will help us in creating the bot. So what we'll do, we'll go here, we'll go to npm install, we'll quickly click on save, and finally we have to install these two packages. The first one will be Restify. So let's get started with installation of Restify first. As soon as Restify has been installed, we will be able to proceed to the next step. In the next step, we are going to install Bot Builder and we'll get started with our program. Once Restify has been loaded, now the second step will be to use npm install command, and you have to save the next package, and this will be your Bot Builder package. Let's install Bot Builder as well. Once Bot Builder has been installed, we'll progress with development of the application. Once both the packages have been installed, now the next part we have to do is, we have to create a file in which we will be creating our bot. So let's get started. Now what we have to do is, we'll open the dir command, and now you can see that we have got a package.json file available, and we have got the Node modules required for creation of the bot. So now I'm going to use another integrated development environment, and this is known as brackets. Using brackets, we are going to design our bot. So you can install brackets as well, or you can use any of the normal text editor to create your bot. I will be using brackets because it's very easy to use and operate and handle your programs. Now what we have to do is, we'll run it as an administrator. Let the bot get started. As soon as the project gets open, you're going to get a list of the directory here. So at the moment, currently I'm into my C drive. So what I have to do is I have to go to my first bot, and we will just open that folder from here. Let's go to file, we'll go to open folder, we'll go to the first bot, and we are going to create our bot in the directory there. So once it has been done, let's go to first bot. We have created that in our chatbot workshop, first bot, and let's open this first bot folder. Once the first bot folder will be opened, we will be easily able to code our bot. Now once your project has been opened, now you can see that we are into the first bot directory, and we can see the package.json file which we just created here. So now what we have to do is, you have to create a new file, and within this file we are going to create our custom bot which we want to design. And today for this session, I would be creating my first bot with the name, let's say firstbot.js. You can create a JavaScript file with any of the names which you like. So we'll get started with firstbot.js. We will be creating this file within our firstbot directory. We'll just quickly check out if the things are working fine. We'll go to C, chatbot workshop. We'll have the firstbot here, and within this, our firstbot.js file has been created. So let's get started with the code. So here, the first step we have to do is, we have to include libraries. So in order to include the libraries, we have to create two variables. The first library will be Restify, which we will use, and we are going to include the library using the require function. And within this require function, we have to provide name of the library which we want to include. So we require Restify in this particular project, and we need another one, and this will be bot builder. And let's call it as require, and we are going to include bot builder here. Once bot builder has been included, now the first thing what we have to do is, after including the libraries, we have to create a server. So server will be, whenever we do a client-server communication, so this chatbot is like a client-server communication in which users will be the client and server will be the bot. So we have to create the server first. In order to create the server, we have included Restify library to create the servers for the bot. So we can quickly create that. Let's create a variable server, and using the Restify object, we are going to create a server. So once the server has been created, we are going to listen the server, because once the server has been created, it should listen on a particular port number. So we are going to listen the server on a port number. The port number ranges from 1 to 56,535. So now what it could be, 65,535. So basically what it has, I can quickly tell you that how you can quickly compute. So basically, as far as a port number is concerned, in TCP/IP protocol, we have 16 bit for source port and 16 bit for destination port. And these bit could be a combination of 0 and 1. So in order to compute the total number of ports available for the network, you can go for a network class as well. And here I would like to quickly give you an example. So we'll be using 2 raised to the power y. So 2 raised to the power 16 will give you the maximum number of ports possible. Let's say 2 raised to the power, let's just use it, 2 raised to the power 16 will give you the number of possible ports. So 65,536 ports are possible, and it ranges from 0 to 65,535. So you can select any of the required ports to make it a server listening on a port number. So whenever your users will be connecting to the server, they will be communicating to this port number. So randomly I am just taking a port number, let's say 4444. So we'll be listening on a port number 4444, and as soon as we start listening, we're going to execute a function. The syntax which we are following here totally depends on JavaScript. So if you have basic knowledge of JavaScript, you'll be easily able to code the program. So now what we'll do, we'll quickly give a message on the console, on the log, and we like to say listening on port number on port 4444. So now this statement is not required, but we are just using it in order to make sure that our server has started listening. Once the server has started listening, you have to create a chat connector. So this chat connector will be able to connect with the server and listen for the incoming packets. So now what we can do is, let's just create a new chat connector and let's call it as a connector, variable connector. We are going to create a new instance of bot builder chat connector. So once the chat connector has been created, now we are going to make our bot connect with the connector. So once your connector has been prepared, either you can specify, in case if you have to deploy it on to internet, later you need some Microsoft app ID and app passwords as well. And these app ID and passwords you can define in the chat connector. But for this demonstration, we'll be deploying our chatbot on our local area network, on our local machine. So we don't need to specify any other specific information. So now after creation of the chat connector, we have to create a chatbot. And this chatbot we can quickly create with the name variable bot. And this bot is going to be created using your package bot builder. We're using the bot builder object which we have used from the package bot builder. And we are going to create a universal bot. And this universal bot will be connected to the connector. So once the bot has been connected to the connector, now you can quickly connect or ask this bot to listen for the connection. So now what we can do is, once your bot has been created, you can ask your server. Server is an implicit object, but here we created the server here. So on this server, whenever we receive a post request on the main path, that means on our URL, as soon as we are going to get a post request, we are going to listen using the connector. So connector will listen for this. And as soon as we get the box, or as soon as we get the messages here, now finally, so we'll say listen for incoming messages. And finally, what we have to do, we are going to respond from bot. So this code we'll be writing here. So in order to respond from the bot, we can use bot.dialog. And using this dialog, we can return the dialog to this URL and we can type in a function. And within this function, we are going to receive the information using this session. So this session will contain the information that with which particular session the user and the bot are connected to. So we are going to receive the information of the messages received from the customer here. So what we can quickly say is, we can receive the messages here. So we can receive the message into something like a variable message. Let's call it as client message. So this will be the client message, and you can quickly get this client message from session.message.text. You can quickly get this information, and now you can check if client message, let's say we are going to write a basic chatbot here. So let's say the client message is equal to hi. So finally, the bot is going to respond, and we are going to use the session.send, and within this session we'll quickly send the response back, hi, am bot. We'll reply it something like this. Then we'll check else if, let's say we're taking some basic conditions at the moment. So now let's say here we're going to check if client message is equal to how are you. So we are going to respond in this case session.send, and we'll say I'm good. So at this moment we are using the retrieval based model for creation of this bot. Later you can proceed to generative models as well. So and finally, else we are going to respond in case if there is any other message other than this. So the bot will say, I don't understand what you are saying. I don't understand what you said. So somewhat like this. So the bot is going to respond in this particular format. So this is the response from the bot. So I would like to quickly explain how we created this. So what we did, we have included the libraries, we have created a server, the server is listening on port number 44. Then we created a chat connector, then we created a universal bot which is connected to the connector. Now we are listening for the incoming messages using this connector. The incoming messages will be received on this URL with a post request. And as soon as we receive this request or as soon as we receive this information, now what we will do, we are going to respond the information. So in order to respond the information, we'll quickly check if the message we have received is either hi or how are you, then we are going to reply. Otherwise, we are going to respond that I don't understand what you said. This particular model which we are using at the moment is, this model is a retrieval based bot development model. Later what you can do is you can proceed towards generative models as well. So we are done with this particular part. Let's quickly save this information and now we have to compile the program and start it. So now what we can do is just go to the project and you have to write in node and the name of your bot. So the bot which you have just created is a firstbot.js and we can quickly start that with node firstbot.js. If all goes well, you're going to get the message that the bot has been listening on port number 4444. So now you can see that the bot is listening on port number 4444. So now what we can quickly do is, you can go to localhost on port number 4444 and you can communicate with it. But we cannot use the identical browsers at the moment. You need to have a proper emulator using which you can test this bot. So as far as this is concerned, you can quickly download a bot framework emulator which can help you test a localhost bot effectively. You can test your retrieval models, generative models and different algorithms and you can make a strong bot on localhost and then you can test that with a bot framework emulator and you can deploy that on internet. So now what we have to do is, let me just quickly show you, in case if we go to the localhost on port number 4444, what exactly we are going to get. So let's say we are going to 4444 and as soon as we open that, so we are just getting that method get is not allowed. So what you have to do is you have to send a post request. This information we are getting is from the node program which we are using. So now what we want to do is we need to have an effective software in order to test this and the software you can quickly download the bot framework from this particular URL. So this is the URL available from where you can quickly download this. So let's just open the URL and quickly see how you can quickly download a bot framework emulator and you can test your program. So once we are done with this, let's just copy this information. We'll go to Chrome here. We're going to open the URL in order to download the bot framework emulator. Here you're going to get the latest release. The latest release for this bot framework emulator provided by Microsoft is 3.5.31 and here are the download links available. For Windows, you can quickly download this executable file. As soon as you click here, the download will begin. And once you're done with the download, I already have the download available, so I would like to stop it at the moment. Once you're done with the download, you have to quickly proceed to the installation. And once you're done with the installation, you can quickly search for your bot framework emulator. Once your bot framework emulator is available, you can quickly run it as an administrator. Once the bot framework loads up, you will be able to test your project now. So bot framework is an important tool, is an important emulator which you can use to make out your tests and you can test your bots effectively. You can test your individual models as far as it's concerned. So now here you can see that the bot framework has loaded. So now we are quickly looking for the services and we are looking for an endpoint URL. So here there are certain URLs. So what I would like to do is I would like to go to my local host and I would like to connect to port number 4444 and I will open this. So as soon as we open this port number, so now we are connected to the chat here. Okay. Now once we are connected to the chat here and here you can see that we are here to the console as well. So let's say I'm going to send my first message. So I'll just say hey, I'm just writing a typical message here. I've just sent in a hey message here. It's being sending at the moment. We just need to check whether both of them are connected or not. Let's go and go for the connection here. At the moment, actually due to this localhost, it is identifying that it's an invalid protocol, so we have to define the protocol here as well. So what you have to do is just provide an HTTP protocol on which you want to connect to. So now you are connected to your localhost server and you can go to the node here. So now let's say, now we have got the messages. We are receiving the messages here on this node protocol. So let's send our first message. I'm going to send something, a message like somewhat like heya. So as soon as I set this information here, I've got this. I don't understand what you said because he really don't know what am I saying. So if I send hi message to him, I'm going to get information like hi, I'm a bot. So let's say I would like to ask him, how are you? So he's going to respond us that I'm good. So this is how the chatbots work. So now in case if you want to modify your code, you can quickly go back to the bot. So and you can type in any other information which you want in. Let's say I'm going to create one more condition. Let's say we'll just use something like a message which will match something like this. Let's say, do you know Salman Khan or something? Let's say I'm just making it a little funny stuff so that you guys can quickly understand how things are done. So now let's say so we have just saved it. Now once you are done with the saving, you have to close this using Control C. Use Control C to close it and start your first bot again so that the changes are reflected. So you just need to make your changes on the server side, and again you can proceed with the bot. Let's say you can send in hi. As soon as the message is received, he's going to respond you back. So now we like to search, do you know Salman Khan? And let's say he is going to respond us, haan wo to bhai hai. So now according to the algorithm which you are using and according to the data set which is available to you, you can quickly create a chatbot for web. In the sessions as we proceed further, I'm going to show you how you can create different chatbots with and without coding as well. In the next session, we are planning to create a chatbot for Facebook Messenger. So I hope you understood the concept of chatbots. You know it, you know the theoretical section of the chatbots, you know the practical section of chatbots, you have already done the demonstrations as well. I hope you are understanding the concept of building a chatbot properly. For any other IT skills and computer programming, reach out to Hackveda. Thank you so much for watching.